The latest on the weather now, a red rainfall warning now up over Metro Manila and nearby areas due to the southwest monsoon. PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres now joins us with the latest. Veronica, over to you.
Good afternoon, Carmina, and all of our audience in ENC. As of 10 a.m. today, the center of the eye of Typhoon Carina was estimated based on all available data at 345 kilometers north-northeast of Itbayat, Batanes, with maximum sustained winds of 165 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness up to 205 kilometers per hour. It's moving north-northwestward with a speed of 15 kilometers per hour. And because of Typhoon Carina, we have a tropical cyclone wind signal number 2 raised over Batanes. Meanwhile, signal number 1 is raised over Babuyan Islands, the northern portion of mainland Cagayan, and the northern portion of Ilocos Norte. For heavy rainfalls caused by Carina, we're expecting 50 to 100 millimeters of rain over Batanes and Babuyan Islands. And also, the southwest monsoon will be enhanced by Carina and will bring moderate to intense rainfall over various localities in the western portion of Luzon today through Friday. And also, we have a gale warning raised over the coastal waters of Batanes, Babuyan Islands, and the northern portion of Ilocos Norte and Cagayan. We're expecting Carina to exit the Philippine area of responsibility by tomorrow morning or afternoon. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Veronica?
Yes, I'm here.
Yes, a couple of questions for you before we let you go. So this red rainfall warning, that's going to be in effect for the next how many hours, Veronica?
So this was released at 11 a.m. today, and the next update is at 2 p.m. So mostly the rainfall warning is good for 3 hours.
Okay. Now, does that mean that whatever flooding we're seeing right now, the amount of water, for example, that Marikina is experiencing, the floodwaters, does this mean that because there's a red rainfall warning in the next 2 to 3 hours, then the water that we're seeing right now is going to increase in the next 2 to 3 hours, Veronica?
Yeah, so the highest warning that we have is red warning, so there's a high chance that in the next 3 hours, Metro Manila will still stay in red rainfall warning.
Mm. So for example, because we just talked to Mayor Marcy of Marikina a while ago, the water level at the Marikina River now at 19 meters, that's the highest they've seen it in the past 4 years, with this red rainfall warning, what does that mean for the residents of Marikina?
Okay, so for red rainfall warning, so it means that serious flooding is expected in flood-prone areas with regards to dams. So we have our hydrologists who will give out flood advisories for various places also.
Mm. There is a concern here, Veronica, as well, that PAGASA failed to warn people about the amount of rainfall that these three weather systems will bring to affected areas. What are your thoughts regarding that, Veronica?
Actually, around Sunday, we were already releasing weather advisories, and in that weather advisory, we have a three-day outlook, and Metro Manila is already included. So we're also, based on the weather advisories that we're releasing, we're also expecting that Metro Manila will have moderate to heavy rains, or if not, moderate or heavy to intense rains. So we were giving out advisories as early as Sunday, and the weather advisory started a bit a while ago, and it started from the intertropical convergence zone, then it became the low pressure area, and now for the southwest monsoon. So we're continuously bringing weather advisories updates for our countrymen.
Okay, but because you said a while ago, Veronica, that we should expect rains and rainfall until tomorrow or Friday, in terms of volume, how much more should we expect? Is it 2 feet of water? Is it, you know, give us a visual here as to how much more water people should expect. Go ahead.
Okay, so what we're expecting for today is we're expecting occasional or heavy to intense rains, and then For tomorrow, we're also expecting almost the same amount of rain for from last Monday until for today, Wednesday. So we're expecting moderate to intense rains until tomorrow. And then although by Friday, we're expecting it's going to be rainy on Friday. However, it's going to be lesser than the amount of rain that was experienced from Monday to Thursday.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. Veronica Torres there of Pag-asa, thanks for joining us today. Several malls in the Philippines coming to the aid of the general public affected by the inclement weather. SM Branches and Ayala Malls across the country announced they will accommodate those who seek temporary shelter from heavy rainfall and flooding. Our correspondent Jeffrey Arnaiz now joins us to tell us more about this. Jeffrey, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. Due to the continuous and heavy rainfall causing widespread flooding in Metro Manila and neighboring areas, several large shopping malls have taken the initiative to assist affected vehicle owners by opening their malls for free overnight parking. Among the malls offering the service are various SM malls, including those located in Marikina, Masinag, Manila, Antipolo Downtown, San Jose del Monte, Santa Mesa, Grand Central, North EDSA, San Mateo, Parañaque, South Mall, Caloocan, Rosario, San Lazaro, and other branches. These malls are providing safe parking spaces to help protect vehicles from flood damage. In addition to overnight parking, SM malls are offering free Wi-Fi access and charging stations for vehicle owners who seek shelter. Ayala malls have also stepped up to support those affected by the flooding by offering free overnight parking at their branches in Feliz, Fairview Terraces, Marikina, and other locations. There will also be designated waiting areas equipped with charging stations, while the restrooms will also remain open even after the malls have officially closed. Robinsons Manila will also provide free overnight parking at their branches in Metro East, Manila, Cainta, Galleria, Malolos, and other locations. Free access to Wi-Fi and charging stations is also available. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Jeff Ferna is there joining us on the line. Interior Secretary Benner Abalos urging President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to declare a state of calamity in Metro Manila. This is the National Capital Region continues to be battered by heavy rains and flooding due to Typhoon Karina and the southwest monsoon. The president has yet to respond to the recommendation. A state of calamity is being declared in areas badly hit by disasters where conditions involve mass casualty or major damage to properties. The declaration of a state of calamity puts in place measures like a price freeze on basic goods. It will also allow local government units more access to disaster funds. Over in Marikina City, the water level at the Marikina River has breached 19 meters. Forced evacuations there continue.